What is up? It's Eldre. In this video, I'm going to be showing you what BandLab is and how you can use it to make music and be empowered as a creator. At its core, BandLab is a free app that allows you to make music from anywhere, all via your phone or desktop. And it's not just for making music either. There's a whole lot more to it. Beyond using BandLab's DAW, also known as Studio, to make music, there's a ton of free creator tools that you can use to enhance your music making journey. There's the AI-powered song starter that helps you come up with musical ideas. There's the practice tool Splitter that allows you to split a song into four stems. There's BandLab Mastering, designed by Grammy-winning engineers. And artist services like BandLab Membership that gains you access to opportunities, profile boosts, fan reach, and distribution. But in this video, to start things off, we're just going to be focusing on BandLab Studio. So if you got the BandLab app and you're wondering how to access BandLab Studio and start adding tracks, to dive in, just open up the app, tap this plus icon right here, and hit Open Studio at the bottom right. And here is where you'll be able to add tracks. And as you can see, there are a variety of different tracks you can add. Let's run through them all. Starting with voice and audio, pretty straightforward. You can record any audio coming through your phone or your external mic. Next two tracks are guitar and bass. You can plug in your guitar or your bass and jam out on this thing. Next one is a fun one called Looper. With Looper, you can pick a pack of pre-made loops and start setting them off to manipulate your track. Next up, you have virtual instruments. So this is a MIDI track with a range of different instruments and different sounds within each instrument, but this is how you get your melodies going. And lastly, my favorite, sampler. With sampler, you can pretty much turn any sound into an instrument by sampling anything with just a tap. Alternatively, you can import your own sounds or BandLab sounds, which we'll get more onto that later. But this thing, crazy. And that's pretty much all the tracks you need to start making some amazing music. Let's look into the project settings within BandLab. So the third tab here, the little gear icon, is the project settings. Here you can change things like the tempo by hitting plus or minus, or even doing tap tempo. You can change the time signature, the project key, and there's a lot more settings to fine tune your experience. With the basic navigation of BandLab out of the way, let's dive into creating some music. To do this, you're gonna wanna add a new track, hit voice and audio, and then you can start recording. I recommend having some wired earphones with a microphone or your external mic with some headphones on. Also, before we record, let me show you a few tools that will help you out. Number one, the tuner in the bottom right. What this feature does is it'll tell you what key you're in as you're recording. I can't sing, so I'm no Charlie Puth. I have no idea what key I'm singing at any time ever. But this is a cool feature for those who know how to utilize it properly. On the opposite side in the left corner, we have monitoring. What that does is pretty much allows you to hear yourself while you're recording.
Hello, hello, hello.
And lastly, if you're recording over a beat and you need to be on a certain BPM, you can have your metronome right here in the bottom right as well. So once you do that, you hit record, turn on monitoring, and you're good to go. Yeah, it's Eldre, and I'm here with BandLab, doing my thing. Doing my BandLab thing. Yeah. Yeah, that's how you record audio. Once you're happy with it though, you can check out AutoPitch for some pitch correction, which I desperately need.
It's Eldre, and I'm here with BandLab, doing my thing, doing my BandLab thing. Yeah.
You can also click the FX tab, which has a ton of different effects to use. Let's try Scotty Tone.
It's Eldre, and I'm here with BandLab, doing my thing, doing my BandLab thing.
Just look at all these different effects. Like, that is insane. If you can't sing like me, there's something in here that's gonna make you sound good, I guarantee it. What works better for me is having auto pitch already on while I'm recording, so then I can make myself sound good right away.
Yeah, it's Eldre, and I'm here with BandLab. Here with BandLab, yeah, I'm doing my BandLab thing. Hey, doing my BandLab thing, yeah, doing my BandLab thing, yeah.
That's a recipe for some hits, all in BandLab Studio. Let me introduce you to BandLab Sounds. BandLab Sounds is BandLab's royalty-free sound library, and it's a great way to start a track. Here you'll find thousands of samples, loops, one-shots, all of that from a bunch of really cool producers from all over the world. With all these different sounds and genres in one place completely royalty-free, it makes it easy for anyone to get started. So let's create a new track and go straight to BandLab Sounds. The first tab is packs. The packs are the collections of all the different loops and sounds from all the different producers from all over the world and all the different genres. Looking for some soulful modern R&B vibes? Well, check out this pack right here. It has 100 samples and it's all super organized. The next tab is one shots. Is going to be your go-to for all the short sounds you need to spice up your tracks. One thing that's really cool is just how organized it is. So if you're looking for a snare, for example, you hit snare and now you can narrow it down by genre. So let's say you're looking for a lo-fi snare. And what kind of vibe? Maybe you're looking for an organic or a chill snare. You hit that and now it's narrowed down. It makes it much easier to find sounds that you're looking for. You can star them and save them for later, or you can add them right to your track. The next tab is loops. And here you'll find all your loops. They're usually between 2 to 4 bars. What's really great about them is they're usually labeled with the key, the BPM, and just like the one shots, you can filter through. So let's say you're looking for a guitar loop and you want it to be R&B. Here you go. Here's a bunch of R&B guitar loops that you can easily start your beat with. Throw some drums, some bass on top of that, and you already got yourself a song. Another really cool way to use BandLab Sounds is the looper track. Looper is a library of royalty-free loops that are really easy to put together and play with and just kind of jam out. It's super fun. So you open it up, pick a pack. One thing to keep in mind, sometimes BandLab will tell you to switch to the tempo of these loops, but if not, just make sure you go and change the tempo to whatever tempo the pack said, just so it can be a smoother experience. But once you're in it, you just start tapping things and having fun, honestly. And hit record. So now you got a full track recorded, but honestly, I can get lost in this for hours. Like, it's the funnest thing to do. Let's talk about using the sampler in BandLab Studio. The sampler allows you to record any sound with your phone and then save that sound to be replayed with just a tap. To access the sampler, you hit the plus to add a new track and then hit sampler. To create samples, you just tap and hold to create a sound. Like I said, you can record any audio. You can pull up a guitar, any other instrument, or for this example, we're just gonna beatbox. And once you've recorded some samples that you like, you can hit these 3 dots at the top right. So now you can save a kit to be used anytime. Besides recording your samples in, you can also use pre-made sounds. From there, you just hit browse. You can use one of the thousands of royalty-free sounds in BandLab Sounds library, or you can import something from your own device. Like me, for example, I have my own drum kits in my iCloud drive that I can easily import whenever I want. Now, when you got the sounds you like and you're ready to record, all you gotta do is hit record. But something I would recommend is to go to the project settings and turn on the count in for the metronome. Put it at like 1 bar, whatever you're familiar with, and then turn the metronome on when you record. This is something I like to do to make things easier on myself when I want to record, so let's try it. And since the sampler records in MIDI, I can swap out any of those samples on the pads whenever I want to completely switch this whole thing up. And that's why I love the sampler track. Let's talk about using virtual instruments in BandLab Studio. BandLab has a variety of virtual instruments ready to use in the app. To access them, all you gotta do, make a new track and hit virtual instruments. You can filter through them with the tabs at the top if you want electric bass, guitar, keyboards, leads, whatever you want. So let's see what we would like. Let's just do clean acoustic guitar. So once you tap it, a keyboard will pop up and you'll be able to play. So let's record something real quick. That's cool for now. And let's check out some of these effects. Let's try ambient clean. Pretty cool. And again, Again, a ton of effects. You can also go in and modify all the different things within these effects. And another cool tip with the keyboard is there's different types of keyboards. So let's say you want to play something within the same key, you come over to smart keys, and it's only going to show you notes that are in the key of D minor or whatever key you have set there, which is really cool and really helpful. And there's also smart scale. So if you click over here and hit smart grid, as you can see, we're in the scale of D minor, and all the notes in the scale are presented to you in these blocks. And the little orange notes are the root notes. Pretty dope. Let's talk about editing your project in BandLab Studio. In BandLab, all your tracks and regions can be trimmed, looped, sliced, key changed, edited, and more. So once you have all these tracks together, you can just tap a region and you'll start to see some of the basic things popping up, like delete, copy paste, loop, or slicing. And also this little white dot there is how you trim a track. If you want more advanced tools, you hit these little three dots on the right. You can shift things ever so slightly. You can mess with the gain. You can transpose it, time stretch it, fade, denoise, all these really cool things that you can do to tweak your sound exactly how you want it. This is a drum loop that technically doesn't need to be transposed. So let's put that to zero semitones. Solo it, see how it sounds. Here's a pro tip. You don't have to edit each region one by one. To select multiple regions at once, you simply tap and drag them, and there you go. Now you can make modifications to all these at once. Like let's say you want to split them all in this one particular section, you can do that. If you want to move them around, you can do that. And then you just long press to get rid of one that you don't want to continue messing with. Simple as that. In BandLab, you can also edit the MIDI notes. So all you gotta do is double tap on the MIDI track. And here's all the notes for the bass we played. And all we have to do to move things around is just select it, move it if we wanted to put things a little more on grid. If we want it off grid, let's unselect this magnet in the top right. So that way it won't snap. If I wanted to have some swing, you know what I'm saying? You can also adjust the length of the note as well. And you can also add in more notes if you wanted to. Let's talk about mixing your project and its effects in BandLab Studio. So once your track is close to completion, you're gonna start thinking about mixing, panning, all your levels and all that kind of stuff. Let me show you how to do all that. So here's our track so far. We got a sampler track for the drums. We got a hi-hat loop from BandLab Sounds library. We also got a melody loop from BandLab Sounds. We got some vocals I recorded and a virtual instrument track with the bass. So first, let's adjust the audio and panning. What you're going to want to do is open up Mix View, which is right here at the bottom left. And if you want to be organized, you can change the titles of your tracks by hitting these three dots and hitting Rename. So this bottom slider is the master volume. You can use that to adjust the volume. You can also tap it to mute and unmute the track. For the Vox, for example, we definitely want to turn that down a bit. But if you ever wanted to raise it back to zero, you just double tap the volume slider. If you want to pan the track, right here, the little L and R that stands for left and right, you just kind of swipe up and down to go left and right. Let's hear that. Double tap that to bring it back to the center. Let's actually go into the sample of drums. Let's turn the kick up a bit. Snare down a little. And as I already told you, if you want to solo or mute anything, let's say we wanted to mute the hi-hat loop for a bit. Solo the vocals. Super simple to do. At this point in the mixing process, we got our levels right. We pan what we want to pan. Now we want to mess around with some mixing effects. To access the effects, you can either press this little effects button right here. Another way to do it is outside of the mixer window. You can also just hit that same button. So right now we are on the sample. You have all these presets, which are great, but if you want to do some stuff on your own, like simple EQ, you hit that plus. And then you have all these different options for plugins. So you got this simple EQ3 and you wanted to get rid of some of the low end on the sample. You can do that. Let's say you wanted to add some reverb to it. You slide over here to reverb and let's add studio reverb to it. Let's go back and solo the track. Let's say you wanted to add some crazy delay too. Slide over to delay, ping pong delay. All these different options, but let's get rid of that stuff. We don't need it on here. As you can see, as you're adding these effects to things, you can save them as your own custom preset to come back and add anytime to whatever track you want. Pretty sick. Now that your track is finished, it's mixed, it's sounding beautiful, let's talk about saving and publishing your track in BandLab. So quite simply, what you want to do is just tap this cloud icon in the top right and hit save. At this point, you can add a photo, add a title, description, genre. There's some additional settings down here. You can select the band and you can also apply some BandLab mastering all in this one app. And there's also quick saving. I should have done this way early in the process. Don't be like me. Save your work while you're working on it. But let's say you're working on it and you remember to save the track. You just double tap the cloud and it's gonna save for you right then and there. And as you can see there, it said no changes because I haven't changed anything to the beat since I last saved it. And lastly is publishing. Same way, you hit the cloud, you hit publish, and now you can publish your song and have it shared with the rest of the BandLab community. And look at that, you just made an entire song all on your phone for free using BandLab. And again, I'm Eldre, keep up the good work, and I'll catch you next time.